Hello YouTubers, this is MusicSore here, and this is my God's a Guitar episode number 4. And for this Guitar Gods episode, I am gonna cover, as I said in my last video, or as I sort of implied to, the artist known as God. Yes. Eric Clapton. Slow Hand. He's had many monikers through the years. Now, Eric Clapton was born in England, has had many monikers, as I've said. Slow Hand, which he got when he started. He had a guitar that wasn't necessarily the best quality, and sometimes during a song, a string would break. He'd have to go and replace it, so everyone started slow clapping while they waited for him to get on stage and all that. And it was pretty good. Now, as I said, the one God, he got that moniker. I'm not sure if it was in between the Yardbird album and John Mayall, or John Mayall's album and Cream, but graffiti or tag started to pop up all over England, which said in them, Clapton is God, which back then was pretty taboo. Like, you never really heard anybody say anybody is God, but Eric Clapton was one of the first ones to be called God in music. Like, just as I said, and also you can say Eric Clapton is a Beatle. For once, even if it is for one song, he still was a Beatle. He's been called a renegade, a blues man, really great musician. And to put it this way, Clapton's been nominated, or not nominated, he's won 17 Grammys, which, if you were to look at this about 10, maybe 20 years ago, that would have been a huge deal. But now with how they've degraded the Grammys and all that, it really isn't. But yeah, so bands Eric Clapton was in: the Yardbirds, John Mayall and the Blues Breakers, the great band Cream, Blind Faith, Derek and the Dominoes, and then his solo years. Like, he really did a lot. And albums he did for the Yardbirds was For Your Love. For John Mayall, with Eric Clapton, it was Eric Clapton's second stint in the band, actually, and it said John Mayall with Eric Clapton, Blues Breakers. And then you get into Cream, Fresh Cream, Disraeli Years, Wheel of Fire, and Goodbye, which featured some great tracks. If you've never heard of Cream, go listen to them. They're absolutely amazing. Blind Faith only released one album. It was called Blind Faith. Derek and the Dominoes is Layla and an assortment of other love songs, which is pretty good. And solo, you had Eric Clapton, 461 Ocean's Boulevard, There's Everyone in the Crowd, No Reason to Cry, Slow Hand, Blacklist, Another Ticket, EC Was Here, Journeyman, countless others. Like, Clapton is a really great musician and all that. And you also look at a lot of the guys Eric Clapton worked with in his career, like in the Yardbirds. Like, to think about it this way, the Yardbirds produced 3 legitimate guitar icons in Eric Clapton, Jeff Beck, Jimmy Page. But yeah, they did a lot with the band. John Mayall and the Blues Breakers was John Mayall, Eric Clapton, and a few other guys. Cream was Jack Bruce, Ginger Baker, and Eric Clapton. Featured some great songs. Blind Faith featured Clapton, Baker, a bass player, I can't remember his name, and Steve Winwood, which, to anybody here that does not know of Steve Winwood, go look him up. He is a phenomenal, phenomenal guitar player, and also probably known as the one guy that punched Jimi Hendrix in the face. Pretty well known there. And even in his solo career, he's worked with a lot of musicians. You had Buddy Guy, B.B. King, Hubert Sumlin, Johnny Cash, Carl Perkins, Stevie Ray Vaughan he worked with, Robert Cray, Albert King he worked with, I believe he worked with Johnny Winter, I'm not sure, he might have, I don't know, Jimmy Vaughan he's worked with, Tina Turner, Bono, countless people he's worked with. Or wait a minute, I'm not sure about Bono. B.B. King, I think, was Bono. Yeah, but no, and even songs like Eric Clapton has recorded or been a part of is another ticket, Bad Love. Oh yes, this also goes into albums. The White Album with the Beatles, when George Harrison was really pissed off with John Lennon. And after hearing a lot about the Beatles, I'd be pissed off with John Lennon as well, but it was at the point where they weren't really talking, so he then asked Eric Clapton to play guitar on one of his songs, and I think it might have also been a sort of, you scratch your back, you scratch mine, I'm not sure how it worked, but I know Badge from Cream's album Goodbye was written by Eric Clapton and George Harrison. Now, the Beatles one was While My Guitar Gently Weeps, which is a phenomenal, phenomenal song. You go back, watch it with the concert in Bangladesh was a great version of it, where it showed George Harrison, if Eric Clapton is rock and roll's god, George Harrison is rock and roll's Jesus. He just looks like Jesus. It's how it works. And it was a great, I think it was just a great time to be a music fan and all that. But to get back to it, songs he did. Bad Love, Another Ticket, Badge, Before You Accuse Me, Take a Look at Yourself, Bell Bottom Blues, Change the World, Cocaine, Crossroad Blues, For Your Love, Have You Ever Loved a Woman, I Can't Stand It, I Shot the Sheriff, I'm Torn Down, Lay Down Sally, Layla, Let It Rain, Pretending Promises, Riding with the King, Sunshine of Your Love, White Room. Oh god, there's so many great tracks. Watch Out for Lucy, Superman Inside, Tears in Heaven, which Eric Clapton wrote Tears in Heaven after his son died. Like, he had a son, and he fell to his death, like, and it really affected Eric Clapton, and that's where the, would you know my name if I saw you in heaven, and all that, and it's a really great song, and even Wonderful Tonight was a good song, but some might ask, what's Eric Clapton's legacy in music? Is, for me, I'll say this, is I think Eric Clapton was, I'll put it this way. He might not have been the first really recognized great band member, but I think Eric Clapton was maybe the first legitimate rock icon. Where you can look at that guy and say, that guy can play guitar really well. Like, not that the Beatles couldn't at times. Not that the Stones couldn't. It's just, I think he took what maybe they were doing, but he went further than what they were doing. And as I said, what's his legacy as well is you could probably go up to any musician nowadays and say, who's your influence? And there's always going to be one person that will always cite Eric Clapton. Because he really brought the blues, like took blues rock and made it popular. Like, if that's a way to put it. Like, I know he wasn't the first and he wasn't the last to do it, but I think Eric Clapton's one of the more recognizable blues rock, and maybe one of the guys that really made psychedelia really popular with Cream and that. Like, Cream is doing what someone considers psychedelic fuzz rock, acid rock, but it worked at the time, and he really did it well. And yeah, that's his legacy. And I think it'll be a sad day when Eric Clapton dies. To me, he's one of the few guys that I watch over and over and over again. I love his music. Layla was written pretty much with him, and actually, I'm not sure how many people know this, but I was reading an interview or seeing a video on it. Dwayne Allman of the Allman Brothers helped him write parts to Layla, which was about George Harrison's wife, pretty much, or girlfriend, or person he was seeing at the time. I think it was his wife. And he just liked her a lot. Eric Clapton's been one of those guys that even to this day, like, still touring, still working on stuff, still working, and I don't think Eric Clapton will ever quit. B.B. King probably never quit. He's in his 80s, buddy guy. He's in his 80s. He'll never quit. Why? Because he just loves the blues so much. They have a lot to sing about. So yeah, that's my thoughts on God of Guitar, episode number, you guessed it, 4 for Eric Clapton. Not sure who I'm gonna do next. I'm probably gonna leave that up to you guys. I might trying to keep it fresh, so I'll probably post a thing on my YouTube page, or if you want, comment down below, like, subscribe, do that. And if you have a guitar player you won't think is a guitar god and you want me to look at, I'll review them and try and get a video on them, because I want to keep this not necessarily going the same way, because I know I've done a lot of my first four have been mainly classic rock slash blues guitar players, and I want to sort of maybe focus on other guitar players. If you have one you think that I'll do a video, because this isn't necessarily an order of like top 10 list or anything. It's just guitar players, pretty much. So, yeah, this is Music Whore. This is my Got a Guitar episode 4, Eric Clapton. Peace.
Was kindness in the heart cry.